ಚೆನ್ನೈ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪರೆನ್ಸಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪರೆನ್ಸಿ ಎನಿ ಚೆಕ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ದಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವುದು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರೋಮೋ ನಂಬರ್ ಟು ಬಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಚೆಕ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೋಮೋ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ತ್ರೀ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಬಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಚೆಕ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ತ್ರೀ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಡ್ರಾಯರ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿ Drawer is the author of the check. Drawee is the bank, and payee is the person to whom the check is issued. Then coming to types of checks, anybody from the audience, can guess how many types of checks you can issue?
Open check or cash check? Open check, cash check.
Open check, that is bearer check. Bearer, person in whose favor you are going to issue the check, bearer check, self check. Namige naave draw maadkobekare self check anta maadtare. Then comes the cross check. Cross check, it is through the account of the drawer. The dishonor of check is made as quasi judicial. The dishonor of check is a will attract penal. It is a penal in nature. How to file the complaint and what are the ingredients of Section 138. That is, that will be the point of discussion. Let us not. I am not going to speak about the Brunot because that is a civil. That you can raise a civil dispute for recovery. That you will have 3 years time under the Limitation Act to recover the money on the date of Brunot. Our point of discussion will be 138. An act and various other sections. To attract 138, what are the ingredients? Number one, the check must be within 3 months. From the date of check, you should present the check. The check must be issued in respect of legally enforceable debt. Debt or other liability. It should be presented within 3 months. If it is dishonored, then within 30 days notice has to be issued. Within 30 days. Calling upon the accused or the drawer to repay the money within 15 days. And thereafter, you will have 30 days limitation to present the complaint. Roughly, you can keep it as 30 plus 15 plus 30, 75 days from the date of dishonor. And if it is filed under section 200, because the complaint is defined under section 2 of Code of Criminal Procedure, it should be filed before the learned magistrate under section 200. You should please go through under the section 200 of CRPC, the section 2 of CRPC that defines complaint. So you have to file the complaint under section 200 CRPC. If there is a delay, before taking cognizance, the court will issue notice to the accused. There is a delay, then enquiry on the delay application will be held. Post enquiry, the court comes to the conclusion that the delay what you have sent in the affidavit is genuine. Court will condone the delay and take cognizance. Otherwise, court can dismiss the complaint. Now, having taken cognizance, if there is no delay, the court can straight away take cognizance upon the affidavit sworn statement filed by the complainant. Having taken cognizance, the court will issue summons. Thereafter, the accused has to appear before the court. Otherwise, penal consequences will follow. Then he must also make an application seeking permission to cross-examination. This was introduced pursuant to the judgment passed in Indian Client Association case. Prior to that judgment, there was one more opportunity given to the complainant to lead evidence. Now, the very sworn statement is treated as evidence in order to, because the offense under section 138 is a summary in nature. Maximum time prescribed is 6 months, that is impossible. Therefore, in order to bring out the changes pursuant to that Indian Bank Association judgment, the accused, the moment accused appears before the court, if he wants to contest the matter, he must file the application 145-12 application. He must contest the matter. Otherwise, straight away judgment will be passed. Then two more sections were introduced, that is 143A and 148. 143A is introduced in order to give some immediate relief to the complainant. So if an application is made without going into the trial, the court can award compensation to the complainant at the rate, please note it, at the rate maximum is 20% of the check amount. 20% of the check amount can be awarded as compensation, and in case the complainant fails, he must give it back with interest. Bank rate of interest. That is the introduction of that is section 143A. Then comes, this is pending proceedings. Please note, this is pending proceedings up to 20% of the compensation on the check amount. Then comes 148. The Enact Amendment, which speaks the 143A, the court may direct, may order for compensation. Please note, there is a discretionary power given to the Enact magistrate. Insofar as 148 is concerned, there is no discretion. Here the court has to award compensation. When the appeal is filed, court has to impose compensation penalty at the rate of the statutory deposit at the rate of 20% on the compensation amount. There it was check amount, this is compensation amount. Suppose give example, 5 lakhs is the check amount. The compensation amount is 6 lakhs is awarded by the learned magistrate, then 20% on the
6 lakhs.
On the compensation amount, that is 6 lakhs, not on the check amount. And this is exclusive of whatever earlier it is paid. Then who can file the complaint and who can be the accused? Complaint can be filed by individual, complaint can be filed by a partnership firm, complaint can be filed by a LLP or company. And who can be the accused in case of a firm or a company? In case of firm or a company, both the signatory of the check as well as the firm. In case of a company, both the director as well as the company. Both are to be made as parties to the complaint, accused. Both are to be made as accused in the complaint. In case of individual, only individual. In case of company, both the director as well as the company. In case of partnership firm, firm and the partner, the signatory. And if any other directors are there who are actively participating in the affairs of the firm or the company, they can also be made as parties, and you should make a mention in the complaint that these are the persons involved in the day-to-day activities of the company or firm. Is it clear? I'll give the relevant judgments at the later point of time. Then, can a power of attorney give evidence in case of the in the complaint filed under section 138 cases? A power of attorney can give evidence provided he must mention as to the knowledge of the contents of the complaint. If he has no personal knowledge, he cannot give evidence. If he has a personal knowledge, he must mention it in the affidavit and he can give evidence. Okay, then comes the notice. Suppose the notice is issued, first notice, no reply, you have not filed the complaint. Can you issue a second notice? Is it permissible under law to issue a second notice? Is it permissible? It is permissible.
Yes, sir.
You can, if the check is within the period, you can present it and you can give one more notice and file it. In case of joint account holder, in case of a joint account, only the drawer is liable. Please note, in case of joint account, husband and wife, they are having a joint account, only husband has signed the check, then only husband is liable and not the wife in case of joint. Then what are the, how to defend? Because there is a presumption that check is for the date, the amount, the consideration, everything is presumed here. There is a presumption under section 118. Presumption with regard to consideration, date, time of acceptance, time of transfer, etc., etc. And is the holder in due course. All these presumptions. How to get over the presumption? What are the modes to come out of the presumption? Number one, you can prove that the debt is illegal debt. In the first instance, I have said it is only in respect of a legally recoverable debt. Correct? So, how to get over the presumption? Number one, you can establish that it is a legally recoverable debt. Number two, it is an impossible debt. Number three, it is improbable debt. There are three modes of defense available to the accused. To rebut the presumption, because there is a presumption under section 139, you can rebut by these three modes. You can make a note of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court reported in 2006. 6 SCC 39 Narayana Menon versus State 2006 6 S, bracket is 6 SCC 39. The Honorable Supreme Court has said these three modes you can defend and you can rebut the presumption. And you can just this judgment you can just note down. Criminal petition 1387 of 2011, Parimala Bai versus Bhaskar Narasimhayya. I quote criminal petition 1387 of 2011. Here is a case where money was given to one person to procure the seat, medical college seat. He gives the check and that was bounced. The court said nothing doing, the very transaction is illegal and therefore the complaint is dismissed. ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದೆ, ನಿನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ, ನಿನ್ನ ಲೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನು. ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಜಡ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನೋಟ್ ಡೌನ್. ಕ್ರಿಮಿನಲ್ ಅಪೀಲ್ 2000 2057 2057 ಬಾರ್ 16.